Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the pectoralis minor muscle. So here we can see pictured the pectoralis minor muscle, and the pectoralis minor muscle is going to sit underneath the pectoralis major muscle. So just as a point of reference, you can see the pectoralis major muscle right here, and you can see just coming out from underneath it, you have the pectoralis minor muscle coming up to meet its insertion on the coracoid process of the scapula. Now if you'd like to learn more about the pectoralis major muscle, I'll put a link down in the description box, so after you finish this video, you can go and click on that and watch the pectoralis major video. As you can see highlighted here in red, I've got the origin of the pectoralis minor, and that's on the 3rd, the 4th and the 5th ribs. So you can see here highlighted in blue the insertion of the pectoralis minor muscle, and that's on the coracoid process of the scapula. So obviously the scapula just behind the ribs here, this big flat bone, and then the coracoid process is this bone that's sort of sticking out of the scapula connected to it right here, and the pectoralis minor is going to insert on the medial border and superior surface of this coracoid process. So we're back again with the scatter model. Let's go over the actions of the pectoralis minor muscle. So it's originating on the 3rd to 5th ribs, inserting on the coracoid process of the scapula. So that's going to give it two primary actions really, moving the ribs and moving the scapula. Let's go over the scapula movements first. So the scapula is going to be able to move anteriorly, and it's going to be also be able to move inferiorly. So as that pectoralis minor contracts, the scapula is going to glide anteriorly just across the ribs, and also it's going to also be able to be pulled inferiorly. So that's because the origin is obviously lower than the insertion. So as it contracts, it can pull the scapula down. It can also pull it forwards, so anteriorly towards the front of the body. Now let's say that all the other muscles which connect to the scapula are holding it in place, and it's stopping it from moving, stabilizing it. Now in that kind of situation, that's going to mean the only thing left that can move is the ribs. So we've got elevation of the ribs as our last action. So if you watch my rib cage right now, as I take a big deep breath, you can see it being elevated and then falling back down afterwards. So the pectoralis minor is going to be one of the muscles which contributes to that elevation of the ribs. So if you enjoyed the video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press these buttons, really helps out the channel. Thank you very much for watching everyone. I'll see you all next time.